to play good roles and stuff like that. I don't think that every people of this kind are used to do tests on their repositories. So when I first started to work with the configuration management tools, it was some time ago, maybe a year ago. No, I didn't thought about testing at all, but that changed because when my repository started to be bigger, I couldn't test the changes I made. I needed to test multiple platforms like Ubuntu and Debian, Fedora, and if you want to test more complex repositories manually, it's really time consuming. So that's what you can do, is try to somehow make the repository testable. And my workflow then was like that I had an OpenStack and I had a virtual machine there, and I just run the playbook or formula or how you like it, and then I reloaded the virtual machine and do it like that. No, it was a really bad workflow. But how can the testing workflow look like? It could be like that I spawn the virtual machine locally, install some prerequisites, like salt minion sometimes need a puppet agent. Then I will run provisioning, like Ansible playbooks, like that. And then I clean up all the resources. So that's how it could look. But I know that you are already thinking about more. You would like to have some framework which could test all the configuration management tools like Ansible, Puppet, or even the HashiCorp platform. And it would be really cool if you could either bootstrap these instances into cloud. You know, if you test something bigger, like the clusters, you have to test them locally by installing virtual machines, because if you work with the notebooks, which are really old, it's really tough test like this. And what you could think more is setting up the CI, which is really important. So I made research about the tools which are available, and Test Kitchen is a tool which was really the best I could find. There were more, but this, I used to say that it is a Swedish army knife for testing and verification of infrastructure code. And I really mean that, because I will tell you why soon, but this is just the static information. It's a tool made by Chef. You already know Chef, I guess. It's open source, it's written in Ruby, and what is the best thing I found out is that it has a flexible architecture. And that allows us to do really many things, even on ourselves. But first I will show you how the workflow looks like in the test kitchen. So the first, we are going to spawn virtual machines locally or cloud, or we can even spawn containers. And we can do it with a thing called drivers. And drivers are actually plugins. So anyone could make their own plugin, and it can be plugin like driver like Docker, Vagrant, any cloud driver. So you use the driver to spawn a virtual machine, which will be then tested. The second step is that we can specify the platforms. Since we are using the drivers, which are based on something, we can use different platforms like images, which you know, CoreOS, CentOS, or others. Then the test kitchen allows us to use any configuration management tool, like the Puppet, Ansible, Terraform, SaltState, Chef. All of them are supported. So you can have one tool to test anything from these. So I think that this is really the coolest feature which is there. And then the things I didn't mention, but it's in the title, we are also verifying, and verification is a step where we want to make sure that things that we deploy actually work, you know, because you deploy a machine, but how could you tell that even that playbooks were run successfully, that it works, you know? I will spawn the DNS servers or command and it will fail, but our playbooks ran successfully, but we need also to tell that it actually works. So there's three tools, like the biggest. This is a server spec, this is inspec, and this is, it's not the logo, but it's a BATS, Bash Automated Testing System. Then the last step is cleanup. There's nothing to tell about this. So we've got the workflow with all machines. We'll run the configuration. Then we run verifiers. If everything passed well, we can destroy everything and do it in a loop until we are satisfied with our changes. So how the test kitchen actually works? You will install it using RabbitJams. It's easy. Then you can prepare your local VM configuration, because if you want to test locally, you need to have something installed like Vagrant, for example. And then you will configure the main configuration file, which is kitchen.yaml. And this file, you want it to have it inside the root of your repository, preferably Git. Yeah. But anything other can work. And what is the kitchen YAML? It defines all the stuff I showed you before. So we start with the drivers, platforms, the browsers we use, then verifiers, and all the concepts are shown here. So in this example, I use the Docker driver with the Fedora 26, and then I will provision the virtual machine using Ansible. And in the last step, I will verify it using inspec. To run this test, there are just simple commands. You will run kitchen converge or kitchen test, and it will do the workflow. But let's go to example. So this is example where I configure my laptop. I have an Ansible repository, and just as I showed before, I will use Vagrant driver and then spawn Fedora 26, use Ansible playbook, and then all the stuff you can define using Ansible playbook command, for example. You can also define it here. For example, I define the Ansible vault password file, and then I read it from there. Then I also made some simple verification, but I don't use it yet. But then for the verification, you can define the test. This one is local, so I defined the test using inspec, and also using the verifiers, you can use the remote repositories. So I just put the link for the verifier repository, and it will be run then. And the verification looks like this. This is, for example, inspec, and this is a really noob verification. I'm not pro to use styling managers, so I use key bindings into GNOME terminal, so sorry for that, but it works. Then the second example, to show you that different provisioners can be used. For example, here I use SaltStack, and I will use the driver OpenStack. So I will, when I test this Salt Formula Galera repository, I will spawn the virtual machines into OpenStack, and then I will provision them using the SaltStack. So what is interesting here also is that I will show you later that this is integrated into Travis CI, and we've got the platforms defined like that. So it's from the environment variable platform, which is defined in the Travis. I will show you later. And so it will loop over the all the platforms you want to test and test all of them. Okay. So if you ask if the test kitchen is just some tool which nobody used, it's not true. It's actually widely used. If you go, for example, use Chef, there's official Chef cookbooks, and many of them have defined the kitchen YAML. If you see in the root repository that there is a kitchen YAML file, it means that they set up some testing, maybe even with Travis or other CI tools. For example, SaltStack have the Salt Formulas official, not official, it's a community repository, and they also widely use the test kitchen. And Puppet, I didn't found many repositories that use Test Kitchen with Puppet, and I think that it's mainly because they have their own unit test libraries, but also a system test library. I found it's called Beaker RSpec, or maybe you are more profound with Puppet. I'm not that master in it, but it basically uses Vagrant, so it's kind of similar approach to testing of Puppet. And Ansible, there are some examples, but a lot of people actually set up the testing of their repositories using their custom ways of testing. So it's not very like standardized, and sometimes it looks awful, but it works for them, so good for them that at least something is done. And with that CI integration, it's actually simple when you use a Docker container for testing, because Docker containers are used like in GitLab CI or Travis. So basically you run the Test Kitchen command, which will spawn the Docker command, Docker container, and it will be tested in this CI. So it's really easy. But there are some drawbacks, because if you, for example, use Ansible, you need SSH in that container, which is not always common. So there are some drawbacks, but I think that the images which are used during testing, the usual images like Fedora or Ubuntu or other, have that already handled. And this is the last example, and it's a Travis CI, which is done for the Salt Formula Galera repository. And this part actually is how you install Test Kitchen. So it's really easy, just some gems, and then the plugins are installed with the kitchen dash and the name of the plugin, but you can find it in Ruby gems. And then I'll move it a little lower. Okay, so this is a thing I showed you, the platform. So in this repository, they defined multiple platforms. So they want to test a master cluster suite and the slave cluster suite, but with multiple types of virtual machines, the images, but also multiple types of version of MySQL. So you can define a really different structures of your tests. If you want to test also versions of something or anything you like, it can be done. And so if you want to follow me or something like that, or see these slides are actually online if you want to look up something. And at the end, I would like to ask you to leave me a feedback, because this is my first presentation of DevConf, so it would be cool. And maybe one more thing I would like to say is that making your repository testable, if you use, for example, GitHub and have your public repository, it's cool if you prepare some automatic test steps, because it allows new developers to easily do a pull request to your repository, because they are more confident when you start, for example, first pull request, and there are some tests, and you can see that it actually works or not, or you can even test it locally. You are more confident to do pull requests. So I encourage you to use some kind of testing. And also I would like to know if anybody of you uses Test Kitchen. Is there somebody? Yeah? Cool. And the other, some custom ways of testing infrastructure code? Not? Okay, so do you want to ask some questions? Now is the time. Anybody? Don't be afraid. Okay, so I have one example. I don't do it live because it takes a lot of time to make it sometimes. I'll try to paste it here. So I recorded this using Eskinema. Maybe you know that it's a recorder for a console. Okay. So here I have a repository. Okay, it's kind of small, but I can make it better. So I run the kitchen test command. That's all I do. And it will start kitchen using... First, it tries to clean up, so it's destroying the old Fedora image. Yeah, I can try. I will need to move it down. Okay. Is it better like that? Even bigger? Okay, like that. Cool. So I'm using Ansible. It bootstraps the instance, and then it tries to log into it. It makes, so I said that SSH is not always available. We'll just run over, and now the the provisioning started. So this is kind of shortened, but I ran approximately 104 Ansible test. So then the converging is done. I see that everything is okay. It will start to verifying using the test I showed you before. This is the first local test, key bindings, it's okay. Then I will try to run the DevSec test, which I don't really want it. It's just, for example, that it will just download it from the GitHub and try to check if your virtual machine is secured, and it's not, evidently. But if you run it in your servers, you want that this pass in the production, of course. Okay. Any questions?
Can I use Kitchen to test the infrastructure when there are multiple hosts? So, because what you showed me now, it's only one host is involved, right?
Yeah, you can, of course. If you have multiple hosts in your playbooks or configuration tool, it will just spawn it locally. So you just have multiple local virtual machines or Docker containers. It's everything is done mostly locally, but also you want it to be done locally to create a virtual machine and test it only there. No, it's just a test for you or for the CI.
And does the framework give me some way to identify those hosts so I can know from one host that the other's IP address is something?
How do you mean that?
So is there a service discovery functionality?
No. It's just for the testing, so you don't... I don't think you need that. Okay, any other questions? I can show you also this example. So that's a repository I contributed to, and here is one interesting thing I'd like to show you. So you can define multiple kitchen YAML files. So you want to have a OpenStack test and also Docker, and Docker will be used in the CI, and this test will be only for you. So you can use the environment variable to show the file you are using, and then it continues just as before. But this one is kind of more complex because it uses multiple types of machines, so basically this workflow lasts longer. Any other questions? Any other questions? No? Okay, so thank you for your time.
Jsem rád, že se vám líbí naše formule. To je sběr antisem.